In case a chi-square test of independence has a sufficiently low p-value, it is of interest to the researcher which cell or cells of the contingency table are responsible. That's why we do post-hoc testing. In essence, each combination of your two variables will more or less show a deviation from the expected count under the assumption of independence. Basically, there are several ways to go about post-hoc testing. I'll show only one that I think is already sufficient. The first step is going back to crosstabs and requesting the adjusted standardized residuals in the cells option. For clarification, the adjusted standardized residual is the observed minus the expected value of a cell divided by its estimated standard error. The second step is adding a few more decimals. Simply double-click the table, and within the editor you can select all cells and add a few more decimals. Now copy this table and paste it into a Google Sheet. Please right-click in an empty cell and select Paste Special and Values Only. The third step is adjusting the alpha level, since I do multiple tests and need to avoid the alpha error inflation. The easiest and most restrictive form is the Bonferroni-correction, which divides your alpha by the number of tests. In my case, alpha is 0.05 and I have 6 tests because my contingency table has 2 columns and 3 rows, which, multiplied with each other, makes 6 cells or 6 tests. This is already the last calculation you'll need. You will now use the norm as inf function with the halved adjusted p-value. Technically speaking, the return of this function is the value of the inverse cumulative density function of the normal distribution. Normal distribution because it is used as an approximation for chi-square testing. This number, -2.64, is the critical value the adjusted standardized residuals are compared against. Negative values need to be smaller than this one, and positive values need to be larger than the positive critical value of, in my case, 2.64. I got rather close with 2.46 for the combination of countryside and yes, as well as countryside and no. Despite the chi-square test showing a low p-value, if I do post-hoc testing and control for alpha error inflation, I cannot observe any differences between observed and expected counts under the assumption of independence. That is not a contradiction, and the internet is full of discussions about this phenomenon of significant tests and non-significant post-hoc tests. Just keep in mind that a p-value, to which it all boils down to, even when using critical values and adjusted standardized residuals, is a function of sample size, which decreases with an increase in sample size for any effect size that is different from zero. So, a non-significant test result in almost all cases tells you you're lacking statistical power as a result of too small of a sample. It could be argued that the adjusted standardized residual is rather close twice. Context and prior evidence could and should be considered in conjunction with the used sample size. After doing post-hoc tests, you need to write up the results, which is shown in the following video.